Alright, so sitting here on the floor with Rosie, we finally broke down and got us a robot vacuum. Ooh, looking in the video, that's an ugly stain right there. Probably one of the kids, will blame it on them. But sitting here with Rosie, and she's worked wonderful. We've got hardwood floors, we've got carpeted floors, rugs, all kinds of stuff like that. Oh, there she comes. And we've tried it a bunch of times in the house. By a bunch, I mean like maybe a dozen. And this thing wasn't cheap. We got it on a Black Friday sale. And me and my wife, it was our Christmas present to each other. And you can see though, instead of actually doing anything, she's just going in circles. I'm gonna lift my head up so she doesn't grab my beard. She's going in circles. And when she hits something, she just stops. Ordinarily, she would hit the bumper and turn and then go again. She has been going in circles like this for like 5 minutes. And yeah, I just realized I said fur instead of four. But I don't know what's wrong. So I'll let you know what I find out when we try to call Shark and see what's going on with Rosie here. Oh, one under me now. It sounds like she picked something up. She's not even picking up good anymore. We were actually putting dirt in front of her. And wasn't even picking stuff up. There she goes. See? Stopped again. And she's all jumpy, like bouncing up and down. And it's hard to tell on the video, but she's actually listening to the side as well. And tell you what, I'm going to flip it around and so you can watch a little easier. In case you're thinking about getting one of these from Shark, this was not the cheapest one either. There you go. Make another circle. You see how it's kind of jumping? Or maybe you don't notice that. I mean, if you've got one of these and it works right, it is super smooth. It just rolls, it'll bump against things, turn a little bit, keep going. It's just really smooth. This one's kind of jumpy and just going in circles and not really doing anything. And we've had this thing for 2 weeks now. Bought it on a Black Friday sale. Figured we'd buy a $500 vacuum for $200 at Black Friday sale, and I don't know. Alright, so part two video with Rosie here. Me and Sherlock sitting in the floor with Rosie. And so it wasn't working the other day. So I looked and looked and looked. I emptied the tray, checked the batteries, all that good stuff. And then finally, me and my son flipped her over. And we're trying her out. Oh, what is that? It's like some hair gunk stuck on there. I'll have to clean that off. But we're looking. The wheels did not spin equally. So you mash them down, spin them just a little bit. This one, it would spin just a tiny little bit and stop. And it would spin this way a little bit and stop. And so we got to looking way down in there. Guess what I found? Found this trapped under the wheel. Now you probably can't tell what this is unless you think it's just a bunch of lint or something. This is actually the stuffing from an old quilt that was in my son's room, and apparently the quilt was close enough to the floor, and it's an old quilt. It's falling apart. Stuffing is coming out, and this must have just snagged some of the stuffing and pulled it up under the wheel. And so we actually had to get the tweezers and pull that out of there, and it kept the wheel from turning, and that's why Rosie was going in circles. And so we solved the problem and got her fixed up, and so now me and this guy can watch her roll around and vacuum stuff, right? All the mess that you bring in the house, like dirt and pine needles and you know, rabbit poop and ninja stuff. Yeah, it's all kinds of stuff. And so now Rosie works better. It's awesome. We fixed her. Yeah.